So, you want to hear a story, huh? One about treasure hunters. Have I got a story for you, Pandora. This is our home, but make no mistake, this is not a planet of peace and love. They say it's a wasteland, that it's dangerous, that only a fool would search for something of value here. Then perhaps I am a fool. But do not be fooled by what Pandora appears to be. There was a legend. Many people tell it. The legend of the vault. My father would always go on about the vault, even with his dying breath. Advanced alien technology. Infinite wealth. Fame. Power. Women. So you can understand why some little kiddos who hear the stories grow up to become vault hunters. Well, I have a story you may not believe, but I tell you it is true. The legend of the vault is real, and it is here on Pandora. And a, let's call her a guardian angel, appeared to guide the vault hunters to their prize. The tale begins right here, on Pandora, with the brave vault lady, me. Next stop, Firestone Depot. Time for your stuff. Who's getting off the bus? You, with the sniper rifle and the crazy mask. You look like a Traxican wrestler moonlighting as a dominatrix, man. And you, soldier man. Are those armor pieces from the Crimson Lance you're wearing? And what's your story, young lady? What can you do? Perhaps you can bake us all a wonderful cake. And you, beefsteak in the back. I'm not gonna make fun of you. Your burps smell of blood, and you growl like a rabid animal. Anyway, I've got some advice for all of you. It's tough out there, and you won't be able to just beat up on whatever you please until you're ready. Sure, you can take from the bandits or find things in the wild, but equipment you buy from my stores are guaranteed. And if you die, you can't get your money back because you're dead. I kid. No need to be so serious here. And if you're looking for the vault, well, you're going to have your work cut out for you. So don't be afraid to spend what it takes to get the equipment you need. You listen to Marcos. I come from 7 generations of merchants, and I'm the best. Want to know why? Because I'm making it out here, in this place.
Don't be alarmed. I need you to stay calm and don't let on that anyone is talking to you. Start making your way off the bus. You don't have any reason to trust me, but I need you to believe that I'm here to guide you. I'm here to help you find the vault. In a moment, you'll be greeted by a funny little robot. Do everything he says. You'll know what I mean when it happens. I'll contact you again soon.
Well, we're here. Don't worry about saying goodbye. I'm sure we'll be doing this all again soon enough. Get off my bus.
Welcome to Firestone. I am CL4PTP. You may call me by my locally designated name, Claptrap. Before continuing, please accept this echo communication device and heads-up display, provided free of charge by the Dahl Corporation. Detect that your echo device is fully functioning. This way, please.
All this stuff.
When you use this device, your DNA profile is automatically identified and stored. Please activate the new U station now. Excellent! Now that your DNA is registered, you have the best in horrific death and dismemberment insurance. Should an unfortunate fatal incident occur, your new you will appear at the nearest station. Now we can head into the peaceful town of Firestone. Please, follow me. Wait, is that... Oh no, not again! Wow! That looks like it could do some damage! Okay, let's get this gate open.
Nerby, 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 nerby.
those some bitches!
I'm really good at this. Is there no end to my power?
Excellent. I knew you were the right choice, friend. Now go. I'll contact you again soon.
Attention, citizen of Firestone! There is no cause for alarm! This new visitor has resolved the problem!
Well, shoot, I thought I was a goner that time. Damn bandits won't leave us alone. Had to lock the place up tight. I'll let you in. Come on! Damn it! Blasted circuits are on the fritz again. Give it a go from the switch out there, would you?
Now that you've selected a mission, you will notice that a new icon has appeared on your heads-up display. That's a waypoint. The waypoint will tell you where you need to go, depending on what mission is currently active in your mission log. Now that we're done with all that, please follow me and I'll open the gate for you.
Looks like he got under Nine Toes' skin. Don't worry, he'll get what's coming to him.
You did it! I knew you were the right choice. Oh, the poor little robot needs our help. Would you kindly give him a hand? That little robot is hurt. He isn't going to last very long without attention. Why don't you look around for something to fix him up?
Dang. There's oil everywhere!
Seems to be okay. Now is the time to get moving and play your part in the journey to come.
Yeah, I'll pick him off the beat, but thank you for visiting Firestone. Farewell, traveler, and be sure to say hello to all the friendly claptraps that await you on Pandora. I shall now continue my fascinating research on the wondrous properties of sand.
Well, that ought to do it. I'll see you in a few.
Yeah. What is it? I think we're done here.
Huh?
need something? I keep the medical equipment working, more or less.
Thanks for the help. You ought to use the machine to sell some.
I might not have needed much first aid kits, but when you get shot, you'll be happy I'm here.
People don't yet trust you. If you're going to ever find the vault, you'll need the aid of the people. Helping Dr. Zed with his nine toes problem is a good move.
What we've got.
What do you want? Spit it out. You can call me Zed. Everyone else does.
One more step and it'll be your last.
You should have seen the look on your face.
Smells like off-worlder. How you liking our planet anyways? Me, I can take care of myself. I'll get by just fine. All right? I'm okay. not a skag, are you? You know, I only shoot skag. Well, mostly, anyways. Don't worry about me. I can take care of myself. I'll get by just fine. All right?
You've done well. I've decided to reopen my Firestone franchise thanks to you. Head into town and buy some new gear.
Like off-world. How you liking our planet, anyways? I'll see you later, right? We'll see you. See you later, okay?
System with his location. Come and see me once you put his bits to the grinder.
about to face your first real challenge. I hope you've toughened up enough.
Who needs a real to get my machine and their scary needles?
I'm really good at this.
That was the first step on your journey. You must listen. Who I am is not important. The first thing you must know, the vault is real. People will mislead you. They will try to use you. Not be swayed in your purpose. Vault is here, and we will find it. This world is full of dangers. Steel yourself and go. I'll be watching.
Thank you.
Why don't you come over here and chat a while? Always nice for a fellow to have company out here.
A minute.
I'll see you later, right? We'll see you. See you later, okay?
Toes. You should give me a drink to celebrate sometime. Might want to check out the bounty and see if anyone else has a job for you. I keep the medical equipment working, more or less. I think we're done here.
That's a grenade mod! Equip that, and you'll find that your booty and with cheese for new and different grenade mods to supercharge them.
You the one killing all the crap when people ask? They catch a ride and you're stoned. Rested the rip poke. I said, not my hat dog down there, know what I'm saying?
Hey, newcomer. I've been looking for you. Man, don't let those son of a biscuit-eating skags get you now.
Gets hit from time to time, so make sure your shield is up to par.
Thank you.
If I'm lucky.
Be sure to hit the boost to know whoever wants to catch a ride with the Scooter Man.
Boys, take him out!
Did you just leap over Piss Wash Gully and one of my runners? Man, dude, tell me when you're gonna do that crap. That was awesome.
Blast him! You bastard!
I sat in the shower in tears for just under an hour. This is interesting, considering we haven't had water for days. I equate my ever-decreasing sanity with that of the population of my dig site. With the investigation of the symbols and glowing patterns at the site, we finally unearthed arguably certifiable proof of the existence of alien life having been here on Pandora. But this celebration was lonely, as I only have two colleagues left. And I'm not too fond of the fat girl, Shimei. I've been told that scientific discovery requires sacrifice, but I never understood what they meant until now.
All right, why don't you come on back? I got something for you.
This man, Sledge, has something we need. You are going to get it from him. Sledge is a bad man who has done terrible things to the people of Firestone. Do what you must.
Doctor, when you got my machines in there scaring needles.
Thank you.
Tanis, Dahl Scientific Advisor, Day 1 on planet Pandora. I have been assigned to this sector by my superiors to find evidence of abandoned alien technology similar to that found by our competitor, the Atlas Company, in the ruins on Prometheus. Technology that many believe made them the superpower they are now. This kind of find seems astronomically improbable on a rock like this, but my benefactors believe in it enough to waste my considerable talents. I've only been here for 3 hours, and I already believe this planet will be the death of me. Scientists do not chase myths and legends. Day 43 on Pandora. At least I believe it to be the 43rd day I've been here. The moonlight cycles are difficult to get used to. The planet rotation day is over 90 hours long. The people that inhabit this salted dust ball are as ignorant as I've seen in this galaxy. When I attach scientific inquiry to something like the Vault, I'm greeted with silly nursery rhymes and slack-jawed soliloquy about a man who knew a man who knew a man. They drift off into a stupor where I half imagine they're drunk or brain damaged and are unaware of my continued presence. If I believed in hell, I would contemplate how it compared to Pandora. Ironically, such a belief would align me with these Neanderthals. I was woken up, hoping I was having a reoccurring nightmare. We spent more than 36 hours earlier today at a campsite closer to our dig site, only to be ambushed by local wildlife that's hungry coming out of hibernation. Half of my staff was eaten alive, or killed by skags. I survived by hiding under a colleague of mine who was being devoured on top of me. His name was Carl. My emotions are deadened, and I grieve for none of them. Point of fact, the only emotion I felt was that of joy. I felt joy because his chair was always more comfortable than mine. I took his chair, and then I noticed the emissive glow on the rock.
Ah!
Yes, and you too can see what it feels like to hold the power of the gods in your hands.
Put it out!
It burns!
Walking.
Fire! Oh, God! Fire!
172. The fat girl, Shimei, was crushed under an alien ruin that collapsed today. She didn't die right away and begged me to put her out of her misery as she choked on various fluids and bile. I hesitated because she was the last one alive that wasn't me. As she was choking and coughing and dying, I tried to enjoy the interaction, which I imagined to be a conversation, as I knew it was the last I would have for a while. I finally got around to smothering her so that I could continue my research. I could tell that she regretted the decision. The Skags have been waiting for this meal for a while. They will not go hungry tonight.
Thank you.